Welcome to Allie's Attic, where you never know what kind of surprise you'll find in my attic. I'm your host, Allie, and today my surprise is a gentleman that does two things. He's also in a band, and he also does something fantastic for indie artists, which we will talk all about. Please welcome from Spawn, and for the love of bands, Roel Wenzik. There, I said it right, right?
Yeah, you said it perfectly right.
Okay.
Thank you, Allie.
You're welcome. So how are you doing today?
I'm great. Yeah, thanks. How are you?
I am good. So you guys, you're from the Netherlands, right?
I am from the Netherlands. That's right.
Blonde hair, blue eyes. It kind of goes hand in hand. Now, let's talk about Spawn. It's a high-energy, brass-fueled ska punk band. And it consists of guitar, bass, drums, keys, horns, and vocals. So talk a bit about them.
Yeah, let me talk about the band. We have been around since 2001. We all went together to school, to the same school, to the same high school. We started jamming a bit in the beginning as a punk band with only three members. We added a trumpet in 2002, saxophone in 2004, later on keys, and also a trombone. It's slightly different, of course, than playing punk music with only three members. Playing ska punk is way much more fun. And that's why we have been doing that for over 16, 17 years now.
Wow. Now, Spawn is known worldwide. You were on MTV. Your, your music video, Spam, it was on there for like several weeks.
Recorded our first album in 2005. Our track Spam was our first single off that album. And here in the Netherlands, we have TMF. Back in the days, we had TMF. It was part of the MTV networks and was broadcast there for several weeks. It was awesome.
Yeah, I guess so. Now, you are now into your third EP, Dance of the Lunatics.
Yeah.
Love the name, by the way. And it's your third album. And the great thing about your music is it's so energetic. I mean, you want to get up and move. It totally gets you going. And I guess this is from an interview, Louder Than War 2016. They've nailed it. With their third album, they've definitely found the groove and locked it down. Dance of the Lunatics is a huge, bouncing, sweaty dance machine perched on 14 legs and having the time of its life. And you guys do look like you have so much fun up there.
Yeah. Also, kudos to that reviewer for putting that line out there for us to use. I think it's a great line and perfectly describes her music. Great review. Sweaty, bouncy dance machine. Certainly Spawn.
Yeah, it is. I've seen the videos. You guys are amazing. I love that you add the brass in there. I mean, I absolutely love it. Talk about who is in the band. I have it in front of me, but I'm going to let you tell me because I don't want to say anybody's name wrong.
Yeah, difficult Dutch names, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Paul Heinen is our drummer. Original drummer with the band since 2001. David van Lochem, in Dutch. He's our bass player, has been with us since 2011, I think. Jaap Wilsing plays the keys, and we have Eric Reberg, the trumpet, Derek Wickering playing the saxophone, and we have Bout, has been with us since last summer, playing the trombone.
Wow. Okay. I'm glad you said all those names. I so would have got them wrong. And you are guitar and lead vocals, which
exactly.
I forgot to say at the beginning, but yes, that's what you do.
You're
that guy. Now, your new album's available on all major streaming and music platforms, Spotify, iTunes, Amazon. I urge everybody to check it out. Purchase it. Support our indie artists. Also, go and check out their YouTube videos. Trust me on this. You're going to love them.
Videos on there.
Yeah, and they're great. Now, you guys are continuing to tour, and are you working on a new CD right now, or...?
We're working on some new songs, and we're planning on recording them maybe end of summer, and then releasing that hopefully end of this year, end of 2018. It's sometimes difficult, of course, with 7 band members to get everyone together and record songs. Mm-hmm. Might be difficult sometimes. It's a longer process than just a punk band, 3 chords and 3 members.
Yeah, I guess so. I can't wait for it to come out. And if you want to come back on the show when you do release it, you're more than welcome. This isn't a one-shot deal. So yeah, I like supporting as much as I can. Now let's talk about supporting, because Roel does something. This is how we met. He said in a message to me on Twitter, you should check out this website and you should also check them out on Spotify. So I was like, what is this? So I went to Spotify, and if you search for The Love of Bands, it is all indie artists. And Roel, every month you update it?
It depends how busy I am and how busy my reviewers are, but mainly daily, weekly at least.
Okay. Now, you can also go to the website for theloveofbands.com. Now, what he is doing blew me away. And I found artists from this music to come on the show. He totally supports indie music, and he takes music submissions and decides which ones he's going to put up there. And the whole playlist is indie artists that he loves and that he thinks, you know, should be recognized. And I think I fell in love with the idea. And I'm going to tell you, I have recommended that playlist to I don't know how many people on Spotify. I have talked to people that I've had come on my show, told them to get in touch with you any way, shape, or form. Because what you're doing, Roel, is amazing. So talk a little bit about For the Love of Bands.
First of all, thank you very much for promoting For the Love of Bands and directing bands and artists my way. Talk about For the Love of Bands. I started For the Love of Bands December 16. I was promoting Spawn's music, Spawn's album, and after a while you have to have something new, of course, to keep promoting your tracks, and I thought, why not promote other people's tracks, other bands' tracks. That's how I first started, with a Twitter account, and a website quickly followed. And I also had the luxury of having a very good reviewer joining me in an early stage. So it kept progressing and progressing and progressing. It's quite a busy job, side job actually. And I have to thank amazing reviewers who joined me on my quest to promote as many indie artists as possible. All genres, basically.
Wow. Well, I think it's amazing. And I'm urging everybody, I'm going to talk about it on Twitter once I put your interview up, but I urge everybody that's listening, go and check it out. Even if you're not an artist that wants to submit music, just listening to the new songs, and it's fresh, and it's so different than listening to a lot of the Spotify playlists, because a lot of the Spotify playlists are obviously labels and kind of mimic radio, and you hear the same thing over and over and over again. And what I love about For the Love of Bands is it's refreshing. You get to discover new music, which is why I do this show, and it's just amazing. And being able to find artists through your playlist is absolutely amazing, because it makes my job way easier.
Yeah, well, that's ultimately our goal, of course, to not only review music, but also let other people discover music through our website. That's mainly why For the Love of Bands was started in the first place, of course. So very cool that you discovered artists via our website.
Well, thank you so much for that. And thank you for being another person that supports indie music, because I think if you, I don't know if you agree with me, but it's kind of changing. The industry is changing a bit. And I think it's because people are getting tired of listening to the same old thing and not being able to recognize artists on the radio, because everybody sounds the same. And that's nothing against the artists. They're all very talented. They're just unfortunately with a label that thinks, you know, well, this is working, so let's do that and keep doing that. So by doing what you do, you're giving us variety, and I think
independent artists do what they like.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what I love about them. Absolutely love about them. And I think it's switching. I think there's more independent labels, more independent shows that support independent artists. I honestly think the industry is going to start changing, and it's about damn time. And hopefully hopefully a lot of the wonderful indie artists out there start getting the recognition they deserve, because it's not easy being an independent artist and getting recognized and getting your music out there and getting it purchased, because everybody assumes, well, you're not signed, so give me your music for free. Well, that doesn't help you at all. It continues your dream and continue what you want to do. So my big thing is support your indie artists and buy their songs, EPs. I mean, some of them you can get them for like, I think it's awful, but you can get them for like a dollar. I think they should be a hell of a lot more, but I mean, that's just my opinion. So I want to like thank you for doing what you're doing, and I know there's a lot of people out there that are going to thank you as well, Roel, because it's amazing what you're doing. And I want to also ask you, just because, I mean, you've been with Spawn, like you said, for a while, you've been doing music for a while, now you're doing For the Love of Bands. I have a lot of new artists that come on and a lot of younger artists that come on, so I ask every person that comes on my show, if you had any kind of advice to give a brand new artist just starting out, what kind of advice do you think you'd give them?
Number one advice would be engagement. If you record something, put a little effort in promoting it. Doesn't have to cost a thing. Just do your research, support other artists. For example, start a Spotify playlist with bands you like, other independent artists you like. And keep promoting other people's music, and if you do it right, if you are promoting your music right, you are also promoting other people's music. It's important to not only support your own music, but other people's music as well. Also, there are numerous ways nowadays to promote your music, and not only on the mainstream channels like Spotify or iTunes. Of course, it is cool to be on iTunes, but there are more ways to actually make a little bit of money. I have been using new websites, beta websites, for both Spawn and For the Love of Bands. MusicCoin, I don't know if you've heard of that one, but that is a new platform where you get paid one coin per play, and depending on the currency market, of course. Without intermediaries, so the money will go directly to you. Another great platform, awesome platform, is Steemit. I urge all listeners to go to steemit.com and get yourself a profile and start promoting your music on there as well, because you can earn some money there by uploading your music. So do your research, basically, would be my advice. Check beyond Facebook, check beyond Twitter, check what else is out there, read tips, go to blogs, my blog, but also Atom Collector Records is a great community to support other people's music and get your own music supported. It's by Juxta John, who I became friendly with over the last little over a year, I think. So there are many different options to promote your music without having to pay for it, basically, just by supporting each other.
And that is great advice. And I love the support each other part that you talk about.
That's the most important thing.
It is. Yeah. No egos, and definitely work with others and help others. The more you uplift people, the more you get uplifted. So, exactly. Yeah, great.
Sure, of course.
Yes, great advice. Pay it forward, always. Roel, thank you for coming on the show. What two songs are we going to hear from Spawn?
We're going to listen to Lunatics, and we're going to listen to Scarantino.
I love that name, Scarantino. And like I said, you can buy your music anywhere online and the places that you've mentioned. Your website is spawnedband.com. It'll be up on my website, so people will be able to click on it, go directly to you. Click the English flag, Roel says, so that you can get it in English. Also, the other website, fortheloveofbands.com, will be up on my website. I urge everyone, whether you're an artist or a listener or whatever, go and check this out. It is absolutely amazing. And get the playlist on Spotify. You are not going to be sorry. And Roel, thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you.
Thank you for contacting me with all of this wonderful information that you sent me. I appreciate it so much. And I love that you touched on social media and, you know, get yourself out there, because that's how we met, and I never would have found out about For the Love of Bands without you. And I'm going to urge everybody to go and submit their music. It's not guaranteed that it's going to be on there, but at least you're, you know, submitting it, and you can go from there. I know I've got, like I said, I've sent some people to you, and I'm going to continue to. Yes. Thank you so much for coming on, and I wish you all the best. Don't be a stranger. Anything new happens, you can come back on, especially once you release your new album, because I love your music, so I want to hear it. And you have a great day or evening. It's evening there, right?
It's evening. Yeah, it's 9:30 in the evening.
Okay, at least it's not 2 o'clock in the morning, and I'm not. Okay, that's good. Okay, well, thank you, Roel, for coming on. I totally appreciate it.
You're welcome, Ali. Thank you, too, with your awesome show.
Oh, thank you. And thank you for joining me on Ali's Attic. Keep checking my website, because you never know what kind of surprises you'll find in my attic. Cheers!